Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guests are the hot young newlyweds on Bravo reality show Real Housewives of Potomac. And they are here to tell us how they keep new love alive in the midst of all the reality TV drama. Please welcome Candiace Dillard and Chris Bassett.
Yay!
Look at you. Hey, honey bun. How are you?
Hello.
Now the hobby.
Yes. No more suspense.
No. Now, what was the suspense? What is that about? Suspense.
A suspense is a soon to be husband.
Oh, yes. Soon to be. Yes.
So now he's just husband. I just got to call him husband.
So we have suspense and then we have husband.
Husband is a
Exactly. Okay. So I get all of that. Okay.
Yes.
So how do you guys feel now being married? How does that feel?
I mean, it's the same for me. Yeah. I mean, I don't think it should change, right?
Yeah.
I mean, we built this relationship on friendship, and it's been the same.
I always say I still like him now that we're married.
Oh, see, that's very important.
He's still my friend.
That's very important, because last time you were here, you weren't married yet.
No.
So you were giving us all the tea about all the drama that was going on.
Child.
At home.
Yes.
But let's talk about the happiness and the bliss.
All the good stuff.
Yes. So how did you guys meet, and how did you guys know that you were the right ones for each other?
Oh my gosh, it's such a long story.
The short version.
We met at work. Mm-hmm. We were just friends for many years. Mm-hmm. And I always say I wasn't checking for Chris as a husband, because he, you know, he was divorced. He had children.
Okay.
Those were not things that I wanted, you know, in the man I saw as my husband.
Right, right, right.
So we were just immediately good friends. And he kind of was flirting with me a little bit. And I was like, Scott, no, thank you.
It really didn't happen.
He's rebutting you.
Okay, go.
What's your story, Chris? You tell us how it happened.
I mean, the first part is right, but she had just launched Candiace Dillard Pageant Consulting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And as friends, like, let's go out to dinner and celebrate. And she said, okay. So we went out to dinner, and halfway
through.
Where
we go to dinner? Where we go?
We went to a nice restaurant.
A nice restaurant, white tablecloths,
yes.
30 bucks a plate.
Oh, he was trying to impress you.
Thank you.
I'm not mad at that, Chris.
All I heard for 3 years of this friendship was, if a guy ever asks me out on a date and doesn't make a reservation at a restaurant, he's not worth it.
I like it a lot.
But you paid attention to what she needed. What she wanted. That was good.
But about halfway through dinner, I was like, wow. Maybe.
She's cute.
Maybe. But I had to make that decision because, again, one of the first times when we met, I told her that I'm never getting married again. I'm never having kids again.
Really?
I said that.
I mean, it was.
Those divorces will do you like that, child. I got to tell you.
And I knew she wanted to get married. I knew she wanted kids. So halfway through that dinner, I had to kind of realize if that's something I wanted to get into.
Don't play with my emotions. Yes.
So let's talk a little bit about emotions and all that happens and transpires with relationships, marriages, on reality TV.
Girl.
How do you protect your union? Like, seriously, it's quite challenging.
On the couch for this one. It is hard, and I think for us, our first season was especially difficult because he was very new to this world, and it, you know, we love the people we work with, but everybody's doing a job.
Right.
So we're trying to maneuver as a couple, as a newly married couple.
Right.
While also making a show and dealing with all the drama that comes with that.
Yes.
And it can be compromising at times.
How do you protect your union?
We communicate.
A lot of communication.
Over-communicate.
That was one of the things I said. If this is something she really wanted to do, and for me, it was whatever. I didn't need to be there, but for her, I had to be there.
Yes.
So I just thought, it's like, we have to communicate every single day. I need to know where you're at. You need to know where I'm at.
Emotionally.
And we need to respect that. Because, you know, I understand it's a job for her.
And you. It's a job
For me, it is. Yeah. But at the end of the day, I have my own job. I got my own stuff going
on. That's right. Keep your own brother. Keep your own brother.
Yes.
But, you know, you guys are the newlyweds
on the
show. And, you know, you have your veteran married folks.
Yes.
Are they always giving you guys unsolicited advice?
Not really. No. Karen is one who, she's been married the longest, I think 22 years.
Yeah.
So we do respect her and her marital advice a lot.
Yes.
Monique does a little bit, but really they're pretty respectful. They don't really give too much advice.
Yeah. And I like Monique.
Yeah. We love Monique.
Yes,
we love the Samuels. Those are our people.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Do you think it's more challenging because you're an interracial couple?
We don't really
find
that it's an issue. One thing that I find challenging is if and when I have children. Today I don't want any, I might want them tomorrow though.
Mm.
I worry about being a mother to biracial children.
Tell me why.
Because I don't know that world. I know how to be a black woman. I know how I was raised by my mom who's there, and she did an amazing job doing that with me and my siblings. But as a biracial child, I know that that is a different walk, especially in this climate that we live in. It can be a bit of a challenge.
Yeah.
And, you know, skin color comes into play, identity comes into play, and how am I going to raise a child or children who are biracial.
Chris, have you began to have those conversations with your children?
Mine are young. They're 9 and 6, so I don't know that they get that interracial thing yet. Mm-hmm. I mean, my son and daughter, they're half Mexican mm-hmm. and half white. Yeah.
But so they look like
people
they're
brownish.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
They look
they're
brown.
Very tan.
Oh, good. Yes.
They're very tan.
I want brown babies too. Yes.
I mean, I haven't had that conversation with them yet. It hasn't become an issue yet. It hasn't come up. And my thing, if it doesn't come up, if it doesn't bother them,
okay. right.
if they're mm-hmm. fine, mm-hmm. then I don't think it's something to necessarily address and make into mm-hmm. an issue because right. it causes a conflict.
It doesn't I have biracial yeah. children. It yeah. doesn't yeah. have to be okay. that way. Yeah. Yeah. As long as, you know, you set a foundation within them, yes. all the other stuff doesn't matter. And let's look at the world today. Yes. Everybody's biracial nowadays.
The only thing weird. About that I do have a concern with how others may respond to it. So I'm just saying, sure. not the children per se, mm-hmm. but more of other people mm-hmm. and how they will respond to the mm-hmm. kids. So just want to say thank you guys for coming.
Yes, yes.
Thank
and you can catch Candiace and Chris on The Real Housewives of Potomac Sunday nights on Bravo. But for those of you joining us just for the 4 hour or for the half hour, stick around because they'll be cooking in the kitchen next.
Oh yeah, and the conversations continue on all social media platforms at Sister Circle TV.
Woo!